two honorary judges. My name is Natalia Christina Brown, and I am from Smokdale, California. Today, I am standing here to deliver my speech about increasing participation and women's representation in decision-making processes. Well, the first thing that comes to my mind when it comes to talk about this topic is my own mother. Why? Because she is a very inspired person for me personally. Not only she raises her children, but she also works in a company here in Jakarta. Sometimes she's even busier than my father when it comes to work. And I think this is one example of a woman's representation in a small school. However, if we want to see further, there are lots of women's representation or women's role in this world. Let's say in Indonesia, based on what I read on an article, there are 97 women officers in the House of People's Representatives in Indonesia this period. It equals 17% of the people who work there. Even last period, it reached 18% of the people who work in the organization. Not only in the House of People's Representatives, but there are also 8 women ministers in Indonesia this year. I mean, this period. Well, what do you think? Do you think that the number of women's participation in decision-making processes is increasing? The answer is surely yes. But do you think it gives any positive effect? Okay, let's see this first. In a school I go to, we have elected students' union leader 10 times in 9 years. 7 of the chosen are women. Only 3 of them are men. Even our school principal is a woman. And I think it proves that women's role is getting bigger in this world. I think it proves that women's representation is increasing as years go by. Because in the older days, people tend to choose men to be leader because they thought women aren't powerful enough to lead. And I totally disagree with that. How about the result of women's leadership? Okay, I'm not here to brag about this, but I just want to give an example of it. Our school is popular for its achievements. For example, almost every year, our school reached the best result of national examination in our city. Not only in the academic world, but we have many achievements in non-academic world too. And I think we wouldn't have reached such achievements without a good leader, right? A good management means a good leader. And our principal, our women principal, has proven that women can lead too. That women can also be decision makers. Remember the question I asked you earlier? Do you think women's representation gives positive effect? I think the answer is yes. I would like to say, to be a good leader, to be a decision maker, you need to have a good knowledge in every side of life, socially, spiritually, emotionally, so that you can live better, so that you can be a good decision maker. And if someone can prove that she or he can be a leader, it means that she or he has to be well educated. And if a woman can lead, it means that she can inspire more women to have a better education, so that we women can prove that women can be powerful too. If men can lead, we can lead too. If men can be powerful, we can be powerful too. And if men can inspire, all women can inspire too. Thank you.